Look, Kojima is no ordinary man, and both Death Stranding trailers are full of hints at what could be Kojima's next big thing. While we wait for some sort of gameplay reveal, the fans have been speculating about what Death Stranding is about, and so I compiled a video with my favorite theories so you don't have to go anywhere else on the internet. I'm Fgeitas, and these are the 4 best Death Stranding theories so far. First theory, Norman Reedus is Jesus. Del Toro is a pastor, and the baby is Reedus himself, stuck in baby form as Del Toro hides him from the evil grip of Mads Mikkelsen. I can see why Reedus would be the savior, and not literally Jesus, of course. Reedus has no belly button, maybe surgically removed, judging by those scars, which are cross-shaped, so maybe his character can be the savior, as he cannot be controlled by Mads and his tentacles coming out of his stomach. He has come to free us. So everyone, gather up and acknowledge Reedus as our lord and savior. Theory 2. Judging by the zombie-looking soldiers and Mads Mikkelsen tentacles controlling the soldiers in the sewers, one thing is certain. There is some form of mind-controlling going on around in this game. Some theories point that the black oil present in both trailers maybe some kind of alien that turns people into mindless puppets, and Mads is just one of them. Further research made me discover that the badge presented on Del Toro's jacket says United Cities of America, which, by the way, you know that's wrong because the real one is United States of America, and this badge has a logo very similar to the book The Transformation of America, which also speaks about mind control experiments. Perhaps Kojima took some inspiration in the MKUltra CIA project and decided this should be a good opportunity to have some mind controlled people in this game. Third theory, the game has 2 universes and they are linked. This seems to be supported by the handcuff theory. You can see in the trailer that Reedus has a handcuff on his left wrist. Watching the second trailer, Del Toro has a handcuff on the right wrist. Some theorize that there is a third character appearing that link both handcuffs in the middle. Maybe Kojima is the next character, who knows. There is, however, another theory that Reedus and Del Toro are not in the same universe, but in separate realities. Well, I'm going a step further and I believe that they are connected. The futuristic handcuffs link both characters through space and time, and that's why the baby disappears from Reedus and then reappears in the artificial womb Del Toro is carrying. Imagine something in the ways of the upside-down world of Stranger Things. Both worlds seems to be pretty fucked, but maybe this baby is the key to what's happening in both, and it's some sort of solution. This seems to be further proved by looking at the landscape. The first is almost like a primitive world, apart from the futuristic cuffs and flying guys, and in the second we see there is technology around. Planes, electrical cords, artificial wombs and instruments of war. Even the rainbow in the sky is upside down. I believe this upside-down rainbow, it's more than just a natural phenomenon. Perhaps this is the way players will be linked in multiplayer, one in each side of the universe, influencing what other players do in their game. And probably my favorite theory, and the most complete so far. So let's get into some weird metaphorical stuff. Although Kojima has been really quiet about his final days at Konami, word on the street, or in the internet in this case, is that the separation wasn't very peaceful. And that's something that I respect for Kojima. Konami may be a shitty company, but what happened between them both is not for us to know. However, the first 2 teasers we got for Death Stranding might be more than just a simple teaser for a new game. It might be a metaphor for what happened between them. Reedus is naked because he was stripped of his rights to play his character in PT Silent Hills. This dead project is represented by the child that Reedus holds in his arm and disappears. Guillermo del Toro also has scars in his forehead, perhaps symbolizing that his creativity was controlled and stripped away. However, in the second trailer we see Guillermo del Toro plugging his own stomach into the artificial womb where a new baby appears. That's PT Silent Hills being born into a new project. Digging further, I found a theory that links the entrance to the bridge where del Toro stands to the PT demo. There is a J engraved on the top of the entrance, and in PT there was a message signed by simply by Jay, a non-appearing character. Digging through the data file, users found that there was a reversed audio file that said, "I walk until I stood one pace before Jack," and that this Jack and Jay were the same character. Could that be that the Jay on top of the bridge is a premonition of what's inside? Is Jay, or Jack, Mads Mikkelsen character that never appeared in PT and is now making his way into Death Stranding? Maybe this is a long stretch, but I found out interesting nonetheless. It is, however, important to notice that Kojima stated in a Eurogamer interview that the trailers are not as about Konami, but that doesn't mean that Death Stranding is not remains of this project. But now it's time for you to also join in the theory discussion. Tell me what you think about Death Stranding in the comments below. Like the video if you enjoyed, and subscribing to Magical Loop will make you a very happy individual. Trust me. I've been Fgeitas, and see you guys on the next one.